हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रीति, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द फार्मेसी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ लॉयड इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, ग्रेटर नोएडा. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट न्यूट्रासूटिकल्स एंड फंक्शनल फूड्स. इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल कवर डेफिनेशन, क्लासिफिकेशन एंड स्कोप ऑफ न्यूट्रासूटिकल्स. वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम वाइटल न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड देन विल कवर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ न्यूट्रासूटिकल, बिकॉज इट इज़ नेसेसरी first to understand the difference between vital and essential nutrients. We have studied about the vital nutrients in the previous classes too. Everyone knows about the basic roles and requirements of six major nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals and water. We consume these in the form of food and are quite familiar to us. We all are aware about the functions and sources of these vital nutrients, but beside these nutrients, there are certain health promoting and essential nutrients which are also present in food and have protective and preventive functions for our body, and these are known as nutraceuticals. So this is the definition of nutraceutical, means these are essential, have protective and preventive functions. The concept of nutraceutical is quite old. It is present since ancient time. A Greek physician, Hippocrates, who is also known as father of medicine, advocated that let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food. As you can see it on the screen also, Hippocrates emphasized the relationship between nutrition and human health. And the philosophy behind this relationship is focus on prevention, means prevention is better than cure. This quote, though thousands of years old, acknowledges the importance of healthy eating and how the nutrients in various foods have healing properties. A healthy lifestyle with good nutrition is vital for maintaining good health and disease prevention. Similarly, there is an old proverb, an apple in a day keeps the doctor away. We heard this so many times. Actually, it doesn't mean that you will not fall ill if you eat an apple daily. It simply means daily consumption of healthy diet will provide essential nutrients and side by side it will boost your immune system. Now this saying is replaced by nutraceutical a day may keep the doctor away. So the health promoting effects of food beyond their nutritional value are gaining popularity day by day. Now the question is, from where this word nutraceutical has come from, or who coined this word? The term nutraceutical was coined in 1989 by Stephen DeFalce, founder and chairman of the Foundation for Innovation in Medicine, an American organization which encourages medical health research. He defined the nutraceutical as a food or part of food that provide medical or health benefits, including the prevention and treatment of disease. Over the past few years, an increasing number of dietary supplements have become available in supermarkets and health food shops, and they are also available for purchase in pharmacies. The term nutraceutical is used to describe these medicinally or nutritionally functional foods. Nutraceuticals have also been called medical foods, designer foods, phytochemicals, functional foods and nutritional supplements. It includes our everyday products like yogurt, some fortified breakfast cereals, as well as some vitamins, herbal remedies, and even genetically modified foods and supplements. Many different terms and definitions are used in different countries, which can result in confusion. So in simple words, we can say that nutraceutical is combination of nutrition plus pharmaceutical, means a foodstuff that provides health benefits. Now the question can arise in your mind, what are these health benefits according to this nutraceutical concept? So these health benefits include some nutraceutical have antioxidant property and thus can delay the aging process. Nutraceutical may prevent chronic diseases like cardiovascular disease and cancer, may increase life expectancy by supporting the basic and vital function of the body, can boost our immune system, and nutraceutical achieve the goals of health benefits by detoxifying the body. And detoxifying means removing toxic substances out of the body. This can either in the form of like replace toxic substances or make complex with them and help in elimination by avoiding vitamin and mineral deficiencies as they are rich in essential nutrients, and by restoring healthy digestion and dietary habits. Nutraceutical concept has gained so much popularity in a very short time span. The reason is various drugs, medicines have toxic effects or side effects, and this led us to consider some safer approach like nutraceutical and functional food for health management. This resulted in worldwide nutraceutical revolution. So this is the reason behind the popularity of nutraceutical. Nowadays, nutraceutical have received considerable interest due to nutritional value, therapeutic effect, and are safer to use, means they have no side effect. Some recent studies have shown promising results for these compounds. To understand better the concept of nutraceutical, let us take an example of current challenging scenario, coronavirus pandemic or COVID-19. We all are aware that till date, there is no cure, no medicine or vaccine available for this pandemic. Although researches are going on all around the world, some medicines or combination therapy or vaccines are in different phases of clinical trials. A few options are looking promising too. In India, Ayush Ministry has given self-care guidelines on how to enhance the body's natural defense mechanism during this pandemic. And as you can see these guidelines in the slide, we can correlate these guidelines with our daily routine as well. We are already in practice of doing them. Like we do exercise, we do yoga, we use spices and condiments in our daily food like turmeric, garlic, clove, mint, etc. at our home. So these guidelines are based on Ayurveda. And Ayurveda is being the science of life, propagate the gifts of nature in maintaining healthy and happy living. Ayurveda's extensive knowledge based on preventive care derives from the concept of Dinacharya and Ritucharya. Dinacharya means daily routine and Ritucharya means seasonal regime to maintain a healthy life. Like so many times, we have heard from our elders about a good daily routine, which includes have proper sleep, exercise and yoga time, have proper healthy diet, which must include green leafy vegetables and fruits especially. It actually boosts our immune system and removes toxins. The basic concept behind the guidelines given by Ayush Ministry is prevention is better than cure. Now the example I have given you will help you in better understanding the concept of nutraceuticals. As you can see, this next slide is about free radicals. So, we will now understand the concept of free radicals, oxidative stress, and antioxidant properties. Our body is under constant attack from oxidative stress. Once free radicals are formed, a chain reaction can occur, which means forced free radical pulls an electron from a molecule and then destabilizes the molecule and turn that molecule into a free radical. That molecule then takes an electron from another, destabilizing it and turning it into a free radical. So this domino effect can eventually disrupt and damage the whole cell, proteins and DNA. Now the question is how these free radicals are produced. Substances that generate free radicals can be found in the food we eat, and this we can include fried and junk food in this category, the medicines we take, the air we breathe, the water we drink, alcohol, tobacco, smoking, pesticides, etc. Free radicals are the natural byproducts of chemical processes such as metabolism. Free radicals are waste product from various chemical reactions in the cell that when build up harm the cells of the body. These free radicals produced so cause oxidative stress in the body, which will further responsible for various diseases like central nervous system diseases such as Alzheimer's disease and other dementia, cardiovascular disease due to clogged arteries, autoimmune and inflammatory disorder such as rheumatoid arthritis and cancer, cataracts and age-related decline in vision, age-related changes in appearance such as loss of skin elasticity, wrinkles, graying of hair, hair loss and changes in the hair texture, diabetes, etc. So detailed information is shared on the screen. And thus, we can see that free radicals and oxidative stress causes so many diseases, and by neutralizing these, we can prevent various ailments. It is hard to watch television without seeing at least one commercial that promises to fight against aging with antioxidants. Antioxidants are molecules that prevent the oxidation of other molecules. So what is the mechanism of antioxidant? Antioxidants are chemicals that lessen or prevent the effect of free radicals. They donate an electron to free radicals, thereby reducing their activity. What makes antioxidant unique is that they donate an electron without becoming reactive free radicals themselves. Vitamin C and vitamin E, glutathione, beta-carotene and some plant estrogens called as phytoestrogens are among the many antioxidants that may cancel out the effects of free radicals. Many foods are rich in antioxidants like berries, citrus fruits and many other fruits which are rich in vitamin C. While carrots are known for the higher beta-carotene content, the soya found in soybeans and some meat substitute is high in phytoestrogens. So this was about the concept of oxidative stress, free radicals and antioxidants. Now we will learn about classification of nutraceutical, means how we will classify the nutraceuticals. Nutraceuticals are divided into two types, dietary supplements and functional foods and beverages. Dietary supplement is further divided into three subparts, which include vitamins and minerals, herbal supplements and protein supplements. Functional food includes omega fatty acids, prebiotics, probiotics and symbiotic foods. The beverages market include energy drinks, sports drinks and fortified juices, etc. This next slide also includes classification, but this classification of nutraceutical is based on functional groups like terpenoids, phenolic compounds, amino acids, carbohydrates, minerals, microbials, etc. Now the three terms are quite new to us, which are probiotics, prebiotics and symbiotics. So first we will take probiotics. These are live bacteria and yeast and are good for intestinal health, or we can say that these are good bacteria like yogurt. Probiotic act as immunomodulators. They improve gastrointestinal health and have beneficial effect on metabolic processes. These are some examples of probiotic rich foods. This slide includes the examples only. And in this next slide, you can see some marketed probiotics. We are familiar with the name of Yakult, obviously. Prebiotics. Prebiotics are compound in food that include the growth or activity of beneficial microorganisms such as bacteria, fungus or yeast. Examples include wheat, onions and potatoes. The most common example is in the gastrointestinal tract, where prebiotics can alter the composition of biota present in gut part. Symbiotic is combination of both, means prebiotic and probiotic. So it contains good microorganisms or good bacteria, as well as compounds which include or which helps in growth and activity of these microorganisms. And examples include bifidobacteria and fructooligosaccharides. So probiotic is good bacteria or yeast. Prebiotic helps in growth and activity of probiotic, and symbiotic is combination of both. Now we move to the next slide, which is about the scope and opportunity of nutraceutical. Nutraceutical is new buzzword in India healthcare market. As you can see the graph of global nutraceutical market, the data is in billion dollars. As per the graph, in 2015, nutraceutical market was of $183 billion and it raised to $242 billion in 2019. According to current market research and forecast, global nutraceutical market should reach $275 billion by 2021. This promising terms and data reflects lucrative market opportunities for domestic as well as international pharmaceutical and nutraceutical companies. So dear students, I hope this lecture will help you in understanding nutraceuticals. We learnt about nutraceutical history, oxidative stress and antioxidants, classification and scope of nutraceuticals. Thank you.